Hello and welcome to video to understand little more about the differences in using filter functions inside calculate function versus directly using the simple filter condition inside that calculate function. We will also see how we can get the similar results using all functions inside filter function. In last few videos, we have seen multiple examples of using filters or filter functions. If you recall, using filter function, condition specified will be evaluated on each row for the table and then mathematical operations will be done. Now imagine that I have provided you these three DAX measures. Now I would like you to guess what will be the results from each one of them based on the explanations provided in previous video. In all of these measures, you would notice that we are filtering the values for 2000 year by mentioning it inside the filter parameter of calculate function. In the first measure, we have used the simple filtering method inside calculate to apply that particular filter. In second measure, we have used the filter function and again we have used the same simple filter method to apply the filter condition. And finally, in third measure, we have used all functions inside filter function while referring to a calendar table. Now, if you are expecting that the results from all of these three measures would be same since we are applying the same filter conditions, then you would be wrong. There are some differences and similarities from using these functions which we will now see. So let us go to Power BI desktop and quickly create these DAX measures and our favorite matrix visual. So here you can see that we have a blank canvas from Power BI desktop. So let us click quickly on matrix. So let us put calendar year from our calendar table inside rows area and then gross sales value under values area. Now I will pause this video and we'll quickly format the text size for all of these visual items and we'll come back. Now here you can see that we are getting the gross total sales value for each of the year separately being calculated properly. So let us now create a new measure based on one of the first measure which we have got. So this will be sales for 2001 using calculate equal to calculate. This will be gross total sales value and this will be calendar year equal to 2001 bracket closed, press enter. So now let us put this under our visuals under values area. Let us expand this and now here you can see that in the background DAX engine is ignoring the initial filter context and overriding it with the filter condition from our calculate functions, which is year equal to 2001. So this is like boss overriding the individual choices and saying to all people to count the red balls. So all the person will get the same count of red balls and hence in all of our corresponding sales for the years, we are getting the sales value for 2001. So it should be familiar to you, which we have seen in our previous videos as well. However, the one more thing you will have to understand is that here calculate is subtly applying a feature of all function of removing the initial filter context on the year and then adding its own filter conditions. So let us now create our second DAX measure in this visuals and see the results. So let us change the name of this measure. This will be sales for 2001 using filter function equal to calculate gross sales value. Now this will be filter. Now we will be putting a filter on our calendar table, be dim calendar. And now we want calendar year equal to 2001. Now let us press enter. And now let us put this in our visuals now. And you can see that we are getting blank for all the years except for 2001. The reason is that when you use filter function inside filter parameter of calculate, it simply adds the filtering conditions to the initial filter context. So in a sale for year 2001, you have an initial filter context of 2001 and filter conditions from calculate is also 2001. So DAX engine is giving the correct results. However, in the next cell, you have an initial filter context of 2002 and filter condition from calculate is 2001. So this is a conflicting choice and sales order can't have 2 years. So the result is blank sale. This happens for other years as well. So this is like boss telling each person to count balls with red color as well as the color of their choice. Now you don't have a ball which has more than a single color in a particular jar. And hence the person whose individual choice is other than red colored balls will not get any results. Now after understanding this, boss will say ignore your individual choice and count only red colored balls. Now in DAX terms, you have to ignore the initial filter context and you have to use the all function. And hence we will apply all functions to the calendar table inside our filter function. So let us create one more visuals. So let me copy this entire stuff. We'll be using this for our new measure. So right click this and new measure. So this will be sales for 2001 using filter and all equal to, I've just copy pasted the previous measure, and the change which I'm going to make is adding all function while referring to a particular table inside our filter function. So that's it. So let us now press enter. And now let us put this under our visuals area as well. So let us expand this to see the entire view properly. So here you can see that we are getting the same results which we are getting for our first DAX measure. So now when you are using filter function and all function together, it will first get the initial filter context. And then it sees that all function is being used. So it will ignore all the initial filter context and will apply its own filter conditions mentioned inside it. So in a way, DAX engine will get records only for 2001 in all the years, just like our first measure. And thus the results of the first measure and third measure are same. So I hope it is now clear to you what are the differences and similarities. Also note that we have used the simple filter conditions of column equal to static value. For other combinations like measures, the first measure will not work. And you will have to use second or third measures type based on the filter functions. It will be very important to understand this concept so that you can write the appropriate measures. Further, this behavior of filter function is also helpful when some of the time intelligence DAX functions will be used in later part of this course. So if you have guys not understood it, let us try to re-watch this video one more time and reach out to me if you have any questions. So that is it from my side guys. See you guys in next video.